Back here on the Army Sports Network pregame show presented by Bud Light. Justin Rocke joined by the head coach of the Black Knights. That is Dave Magarity. Coach, going up this weekend to take on a very talented BU team. And one of the interesting things about the situation at Boston University is during their home games at Case Gym is they wear their masks during the game, and it is a requirement for both the home and visiting team to wear the masks during the game. So how have you guys sort of prepared for that this weekend, considering that's something you may have had to do during practice, but never during an actual game so far this year?
Yeah, no, we practiced all week, you know, with the masks, and we actually got, you know, got the players a specific mask that we felt was probably the best one. I actually wear it every day. And it just, I think it's a lot more breathable in terms of when it's on, it's not as constricting. So, but having said that, I mean, I've watched some of these teams that do wear the mask, not to name names, but like half of the time their masks are, you know, all the way down or halfway down or whatever. So I'm not sure exactly what that's all about. But if you're going to wear it, you should probably wear it the right way.
Obviously, one of the big stories around the team this week, of course, is the great news. Sabria Hunter named the Patriot League Player of the Week. Thinking back to it a year ago at this time, she's rehabbing a major lower body injury. And now a year removed from it, she's the league's Player of the Week, coming off a career performance on Sunday. Are you surprised at all at where she is, considering where she was a year ago? And how proud are you of her that she's been able to reach this point already after suffering that injury a year ago?
Well, it was never a question in my mind. It was more a matter of when. You know, I knew she'd get back. I mean, she's got the most incredible approach and mentality in terms of how she's handled everything. And you know, for a young kid to handle that kind of adversity and to do it with such passion and commitment is just a true indication of the type of person she is. And somebody, I mean, I knew that when I recruited her. She was special, you know, as a recruit. We knew that coming in. You saw how special she was as a plebe, her first 7 or 8 games. And we all agree that she was probably on her way to being, if not the rookie of the year, probably a strong candidate for that title. And it just broke my heart last year, but I'm so proud of where she is now. And, you know, and I think she deserves everything, you know, based on that.
And we'll talking about her injury and all the issues that come from that. Obviously, there are a bunch of injured players on your roster right now that are watching Sabria go out there and play at that high level that she did this weekend. Do you think she's a great example for these players who are hurt right now, next year and down the line, to say, hey, we watched Sabria come back and battle from this injury and was able to find success, we could do the same thing too?
No, there's no question about that. I mean, what a great example and sort of somebody to emulate. You know, whether it's Lindsey Skaman or certainly Mel George and Mackenzie Muse. I mean, those young kids, you know, it's been hard. It's been really hard. And, you know, we've rehashed this over and over again about how this is not the team that I envisioned. This is not the team that we constructed, you know, but that's it is part of the game. It's part of the business of basketball, and I've lived through this my entire career, you know, and, you know, I could rattle off dozens of examples of teams that, you know, were through no fault of anybody's missing some of their top players or key players. And basketball is so unique too. It's so different than say football or soccer, because five people, I mean, that's the smallest team, you know, out there when you compare it to other sports. Baseball, and I mean, one player could make all the difference in the world, you know, at every level, you know, from the NBA on down.
One of the great things about your team is the camaraderie and the love that they seem to have for one another, and no big greater example of that was particularly last Sunday during the game, before the game, after the game. There's just an amazing relationship between you and your staff, your players, and the support group. How does that make your job easier, knowing that everybody's willing to buy in to the team atmosphere, not just individual accolades?
Well, you know, as a coach, I've never really, you know, one of the things that's hard about being a coach is that you're the one that's got to make some tough decisions. And, you know, in terms of coaching decisions, whether who plays, who doesn't, how much they play, if they don't play at all, you know, and that creates issues, you know, and then you get parental involvement sometimes where, you know, I've seen it my entire career. I was a parent of a player. You know, I was a parent of a Division One, high level Division One player. And there were a lot of things I didn't particularly agree with, but that's, you know, it is what it is. You do the best you can. You make decisions based, and you know, it's not an exact science in any way, shape, or form. You do what you feel is the right thing to do. But what the most important thing for me is what you said, is you create that family atmosphere within that team. You know, so, I mean, I've been on teams where they won, they, you know, knowing that, like, it's almost they won despite me, or they, you know, they were mad at me, but they were always so together. And that's very much the way this team is. And I think they are so committed to each other. They're such an unselfish group, and they have each other's back that, honestly, you know, that goes a long way. But as a coach, you know, I'm always challenging them to, you know, to be better. I mean, I think our biggest challenge this year has been consistency. You know, why was it that we didn't look like we were showing up for games on a Saturday, but then, you know, we were able to win those games against the same opponent on a Sunday? I mean, that happened how many times? And it still bothers me. And, you know, I hope it doesn't happen this weekend, but, you know, it is something you got to deal with from game to game.
It's no small task this weekend taking on a BU team, although they've had somewhat of a pretty much a hiatus since the last time they faced off against you guys. But they are a really talented team, particularly on the defensive end. You did well on offense against them on that Sunday matchup. How do you try and emulate against them this weekend? Because obviously they are so talented on the defensive end, both on the perimeter and inside with Marin Durant.
Yeah, we were probably, when you put together, it's probably other than maybe the weekend up at Colgate in terms of, but the level of competition, the talent level that BU has, I mean, clearly, along with Bucknell, in my mind, they're two most talented teams in the league. You know, I think, you know, Lehigh's very good, but you know, BU has one loss to us. They've only played one game since we beat them back in mid-January. So they played one game in a month. I mean, we're going, you know, we're playing this weekend. It's the 13th and 14th of February. So, I mean, we're concerned. I mean, they're well rested, I would think. I don't really know if they have any issues with injuries, but I watched their game against Lafayette. They didn't play particularly well up until the fourth quarter. And then they just, you know, they put it in another gear and just, boom, won that game going away after being down the whole game. So I'm sort of happy at least they got that game in, because we'd be playing them after – we'd be the only – you know, their last game would have been a loss to us.
Head coach of the Black Knights, Dave Magarity, thank you as always for taking the time to join us. Have a great time this weekend. Looking forward to talk to you after the game.
Thanks very much.
Coming up next on the pregame show, we'll have starting lineups and tip-off. You're listening to the Army Sports Network pregame show presented by Bud Light.